Thanks for looking at feet and inches calculator. If you're new, I would recommend checking out the tips. It walks you through a few different features of the calculator. Everything is clickable, an example problem, and how to get to the help menu. So also check out the help where I have a bunch of examples. Every time you see a down arrow, you can expand and see more detail. View the layout. Learn about the history feature. Watch a few videos, and if you get stuck or have a question or any sort of comment, feel free to reach out, ask a question, and I'll usually get back to you within the hour, if not later that day. So let's go ahead and do a basic calculation, 2 feet plus 3 feet. And you'll notice we have two number pads. The top one is for feet, and the bottom one here is for inches. So we'll do 2 feet and hit add. 3 feet equals. Pretty straightforward, nothing to it. So let's go ahead and try something a little more complex. 2 feet, 1/2 inch. So we'll go 2 on the feet panel. And for the fraction of an inch, just go to the fraction column and select 1/2 inch. Then add 6 3/16 of an inch. So in the inches panel, we'll hit 6. And then scroll down to get 16ths. 3/16 equals. So pretty straightforward. Now you'll notice that we have 3/4 of an inch, but we added 1/2 3/16. So if you go to settings, there's actually a fraction precision where you can change how precise you want your output to be. So now it shows us the 16ths. On the top right, you'll notice that we have a decimal output. This can be feet. You click on it, you can change the number of decimals. You can change it to inches, meters, centimeters, whatever you want. So let's go ahead and review the calculations we've done. You can click on the history button here. And we're on calculation 2 of 2. We have 2 feet, 1/2 inch, and 6 3/16. And we can go back and look at the first one. Now let's say we made a mistake and we really meant to say 2 foot 2 instead of 2 feet. So just click the edit button here and you can adjust. Maybe you want 3/8 of an inch. So it's easy to adjust and go back and fix an old calculation. And if you hit the back button on the first calculation, you can continue with that first calculation. So you can always stop, go do something else, and come back to a calculation you're working on. So a lot of you have requested to have something other than the wood theme. So if you go to settings and click on change for theme, you have plenty of options to choose from. You can even send me an email and recommend a color scheme and I will add it to it. So there we go. Let's go back to classic. So let's start doing slightly more complex calculations. Let's do 2 feet times 2. So 2 feet times, you can do any pad, equals 4 feet. Pretty straightforward. But let's say you want to calculate area. So if you go to settings, we can go to the advanced layout. Or you can, if it's cleared, you can change it in the top corner. So you'll notice when you click advanced, you get other options for input, feet, yards, miles, percent, mil, and on bottom you get metric units. And you also get these two buttons here, multiply by dimension, divide by dimension, which is different than multiplying by a number or dividing by a number. So let's go ahead and say 2 feet times 2 feet equals area. So go back to feet to make it easy. So 2 feet times 2 feet is 4 square feet. Or let's say you want to calculate volume. If you're working on a sidewalk, you might have 20 feet by 4 feet by 4 inches, and you want that in yards. So you get just under 1 cubic yard. The calculator is also really good at converting units. Let's say you have 173 centimeters. You want to know how tall you are. Just hit equals. You get your imperial feet and inches on the top left, and whatever you choose in decimal form on the top right. If you're working with cabinets, you might want to view inches only. So under settings, just toggle that on. And now all of your output will be in inches. And let's say, you know, 173 centimeters, maybe it's not exactly 68 and 1/8 of an inch. You can go and turn on the rounding indicator, and that'll let you know if you're slightly above or slightly below or exactly on a certain value. So let's go ahead and look at a couple other features. You'll notice this triangle here, that's a new feature. We can calculate the pitch of a roof or a hypotenuse. So if we have a 10-foot run by a, we'll call it, we can mix it up, 2 meters. Our output's in inches only, so let me go turn that off. So let's go back to 10 feet by 2 meters. And that gives us a hypotenuse of 11 foot 11. And our pitch is 7.9 out of 12. Or let's say we want a 4:12 pitch on 2 meters. It'll calculate the rest. Also, if you want to calculate a series, let's say you want to measure every 6 1/4 inch, do 6 and scroll back up to 1/4 equals, and then hit the three dots up here, and it'll show you every 6 1/4 inches to make it easy to mark off if you're doing repeated cuts. So if you have any questions whatsoever, please feel free to send me an email. You can contact me through the app, click the Ask a Question button, or my email is on the Play Store, or if you clear and go to tips, my email is somewhere in here. There you go. So I hope you enjoy the app. If you have any suggestions, please send me an email, or any questions, I'm more than happy to answer them.